Hey there, everybody. How you doing? It's me, your boy, Tree Chopples here. Welcome back to another episode of the Minecraft Guide. Today's episode, it's quite simple, you see. In today's episode, we have one goal. One goal only. Nice and easy this time. Tree chopping. Like the name says, tree chopping. That's all we're doing. So, I think what I figured I would do here is just chop trees, and I'll turn the game volume up to, like, max out. All right. Enjoy. All right, fine. We'll make a deal. Don't leave the video, smash like, and I won't make the whole episode all about tree chopping. Just the beginning part, okay? Yep, fine, deal. Good. Now, of course, you already know. Last episode, we got a Fisher Villager. We got just about the best name in the world for the Fisher Villager. Correction, we got just about the second best name in the world for the Fisher Villager. Axolotl can simply not be topped. That's a really good name. Anyways, we got a Fisher Villager, built a new building for the Fisher Villager. It's pretty nice. In today's episode, we'll be continuing the village project that we started last episode by adding another villager to our setup. Today we're gonna set up an area for a butcher villager, the amazing butcher villager. And good news, butcher villagers, they're actually a lot more useful than fisher villagers. Now when you hear butcher villager, what do you think of? Well me, I personally think of two things. Of course, I think of a butcher villager. Yep, really straightforward. So butcher villager, but I also think of pigs. So I'm sorry for this next one, pigs, but we're gonna set up a pig pen next to the butcher villager. The outlook isn't looking good for pigs, but it'll be okay. The home will be really aesthetic looking. It'll look cool. So, and then we'll have a pig farm in the world too. So today, butcher villager, pig farm. You won't catch me making the same mistake twice. No, never. Look, it's on this time. The villager breeder and the villagers are gonna breed right now, and the villagers gonna grow up. Look, before we do anything, yes, do the dance. Let's go. Okay, we have Sparkles. They've claimed the beds. I don't really want to abandon this on, because next thing you know, you come back and there's like 50 baby villagers, which isn't exactly what I need. It's not the worst thing in the world, though. Are you gonna do anything right now? All right, well, we're just gonna let them do their thing. So, I've been busy over here doing a little bit of building off camera. Okay, not really so much building, just kind of flattening and clearing. The area is just about finished now. I also went a little crazy here and did some terraforming. I know, crazy. So, this is the back of the bee farm, obviously. We need to be able to access these dispensers so we can get shears in there. So, I did terraforming like one block away. I feel like that actually looks pretty good. It makes it like not so flat looking. Anyways, the place that I cleared up, it should be more than enough space. I don't know if we're gonna leave everything 100% flat or if we're gonna make stuff go down, up, that type of thing. I guess we'll find out later though. So, crafting tables, stone cutters, set those down. Now, I think what we wanna start with is probably fences. So, the goal today is a pig pen and a villager house, a two-in-one. I'm thinking that the villager house will sit at the back of the pig pen will be right in front of it. Today, it might be a little bit risky. I might regret this one later, but I think we could maybe actually let the villager like walk around, like the villager can actually come out of its house and walk into the pig pen. That might be a really bad idea actually if lightning strikes, but it's fine, we're gonna go with it anyways. So the pig pen, I've thought about this one a little bit. I have to be honest, this is what I think I want to do. I want to go down this way and then up like that. I think that could be really, really cool, and then we'll put like a trap door on top, probably spruce. That could be awesome. But that wouldn't be big enough. Definitely not. We need more fences. I'm already out. But also, before we do anything, let's figure out this building. Like, do we move this thing forward at all? So, I'm thinking the building could be small. 3 is a good number to work with. We could go like this way. Or actually, you know what? No. Let's make it more interesting. We'll skip the corners. Look at this. This gets crazy. Let's see. We could go, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe we have like an entrance bit that pops out here, so that'll go like that, and then maybe one more block over there. Maybe that would be good. Or you know what I could do? That's what I could do. Of course. I could finish off the fence line right here, and then I'll know exactly how wide this pen is gonna be. So what is this, a section of five? Yeah, a section of five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have this beam. Then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we have another one. That's gonna go right back. Maybe the building gets a little bit longer. That might look better. But wait, actually, is this gonna line up like perfectly already? Wait. Okay, so that's gonna go there, that's gonna go there. Okay, no. We just make the building one block. Or wait, no, it lines up. Okay, that's perfect. Sweet. That's cool, because I was really happy with that. Okay, so this is gonna go this way like that. Yeah, nice. Mm-hmm. Then we're gonna have the entrance right there. So we'll walk in, and then we just have a small building. This is all the villager needs. That's perfect. And I'm sure the villager will be like insanely happy with that building, because otherwise the villager it wouldn't even exist. So it better be happy with that building. Okay, but currently we're like a pig, kind of, to be honest, because we're stuck inside of this pen. That's not good at all. So what I think we need to do is maybe put the fence gate there and a fence gate there. So we'll have like two entrance bits on the front of this pen. That'll be good. And then of course we're gonna add a pig crusher in here somewhere. I'm really sorry, pigs, it's not your day. Maybe we put a pig crusher, I don't know, we could probably fit it in over here. Or do we like put it actually inside of the pen? No, I feel like it should sit outside of the pen. It might be a little bit close to the bee farm though. But I feel like we have so much stuff over here. Oh no. Okay, this is what we'll do. We'll try and work in like over here, front corner right there, so it's not too close to the bee farm, so we definitely have enough room for the thing. Yeah, that should be pretty good. So let's work on the building. First things first, terracotta. You know what I said last episode. You heard it and I meant it. That's right. Terracotta today, I think light gray might be really cool, because light gray kind of reminds me of pigs. Like, it's kind of pinkish, but it's like not insanely pink like the pink terracotta. It's kind of grayed out. I think that'll look pretty good. The stone bricks that I put down, I'm actually like really happy with it. The stone bricks were meant to be kind of like an outlining block, but I guess that kind of works. So we're going to leave the stone bricks. Then I'm thinking spruce on this build. Don't really know how tall we want to go. We definitely want to make it taller than this bit, because we're going to have a separate roof line on that. So maybe like that height, and then we're like one higher, and we could strip it actually to make it look cool. That might be a problem though with that. We'll have to get the building in and see. That might be too much stripped wood. Yeah, you know what? Now that I think about it, that might be really pushing it with the strip wood over here, because we have strip wood there, strip wood over there, strip wood here. We're gonna try it, and maybe it'll work. And then if it works, this will be the last build over here that we use strip wood on. We're gonna have to switch it up, because it's gonna start to look really, really samey. So this bit will go all the way up to here, I think. Like that, then temporary block there. We're gonna put a window on the front of the build, of course. Strip all of that. This is where a window goes. All of this gets stripped. We could actually probably put a window on the side of the build too. Maybe this window doesn't go to the floor though. I am thinking that, well, yikes. Yeah, we'll keep the floor on the ground. So that window will get tall too. We'll do that, that's fine. Then the back wall. Now, we're gonna have a butcher villager working in here, which means smoker. We need smoker workstations. I think we could maybe do two smoker workstations. That could be pretty cool. And these smoker workstations could actually sit on this back wall. Maybe we put them right there, and then this is gonna pop out, and that's gonna pop out. We're gonna do something a little bit more interesting. Now, we're gonna move the wall back a little bit with cobblestone, I think. And this cobblestone is gonna go straight up for a ways. We're gonna make like a chimney back here. So for now, we'll just do that, that's fine. And then we'll catch everything else up. That's gonna be stripped right there. Over here, same deal. This is gonna get logs. Oh no, wait. Oh, never mind. Yeah, I meant to say same deal over here, same deal over here, and then same thing right there too. Now, usually I would be setting this up for a fence gate, and that would actually work. We could do a door and a fence gate so the villager is trapped in here. But like I said, I think we're gonna let the villager walk around today with this build, and we're just gonna have to check on the villager a lot. I don't know, I might change my mind on that one. That feels like it could be kind of dangerous, but the building size, definitely good. That's perfect so far. So roof line, let's figure this one out. This one is gonna be really straightforward. It's just gonna be staircases right here, normal peak, 45 degree angle. Okay, yep, just like that. That's perfect, that's fine, that's good. Don't need to overthink that one. But, however, the rest of the build. So, we have a window right there. It could be cool to do like a curve, maybe above the window. So I think we would start there with a slab and then come in with staircases. I think that's how we would do that. And this roofline needs to be higher than the other ones too. But that's where the staircase goes. Okay. So restart. We will lower it a little bit. We'll put a slab right there. That's where we start. We'll do a slab there. I think we're higher than it. So staircase, then another staircase over there. Jump over to the other side, and we put a slab where that dirt block is, I think. So that's a slab, that's a staircase, that's a staircase, that's a slab, that's a slab, that's a slab. Just like that. What do we think? Yeah, it's a little weird over there. I think that works up. That's cool. Then, I think what we could maybe do on the rest of the front here is something a little bit different. What if this time we just do staircases going all the way across the rest of the front, and then we would come in here with slabs and fill that in to make it look good. But I feel like it should probably hang one past over there because that's what we did on that side. So yeah, staircases like that on that side. That's good. Now let's see if we can figure out this side. Probably the same thing. We'll start with a slab. Then we could maybe do a staircase this time. Then what if we did a slab there and jump over to the other side? Okay, so start it in the same spot, the staircase. Then... Wait, hold on. I feel like it should always be staircase next to the staircase. So we'll do staircase next to the staircase like that. And then here we do that and then this and then that. Maybe it's going to be a little bit of a different shape than the other side, but that's good. I feel like that works. So that's that. That looks pretty good. Now the next layer, right? I'm thinking about trying something else new. So what we want to do, I think here is start with slabs to fill that in so that looks like a solid outline of... That's gonna have to change. We need a different block for that roof line. But anyway, we'll finish what we were just talking about. So the top part, a dark oak wood on the top of the roof, probably staircases, definitely slabs as well. I don't know if we'll need any solid blocks. So up here, instead of doing the framing like going up on the sides or anything like that, this time we'll do the framing of the roof, so like the stone bricks all the way around. And then, I think we start something entirely different, but the only question is, how do we do it above this to make this look like normal? So, I think we could do this, like we could curve it up and over, or we could have that go straight back, but I feel like curving it up and over is probably the way. Then, maybe we just do the same exact thing that I was doing. So, like, staircases starting right there, that's gonna be a little weird, but it's fine. And the staircase is over here going up. All right, okay. Then maybe we do slabs like that, like going up even more. Okay, now the only thing that's weird here is this really square corner right there. That's kind of square too, but really that one because of the staircase. But honestly, I think it'll be fine. Now, the top of the build, I think we just go up to a peak like that. I think that's how we finish the roof. I can't believe I had exactly enough slabs. Yeah, I feel like that looks pretty good. Other than that bit right there, that's really bad looking. It needs to change. All right, hear me out here. How about this? This stone and andesite, so it's similar, but it's different, but it's similar. Does stone and andesite work? I don't know. It blends in a lot, but I think it kind of works. Let's go with stone and andesite in there. Okay, so that's the build. I think that's actually looking really good. That's good for now. Now, let's actually go ahead and make the pig crusher really quick. So, we need a chest right here, and then we're going to put it over here. The question is, how do we do this? Do we like, set it back a little bit? I think maybe we set it back a little bit. Like, do we put that there, and we go up right there? But then how do we keep the pigs from climbing it? That's tricky. So let's see, if we were to do this like this, we would dig down there, we have a staircase right there, then we're gonna do this with blackstone, I think that's kinda cool, kinda different, then we have that. What we could do is this here, we could do fences going around that would technically work, or maybe even better, we could just take these fences out right here and change the shape of the pen. So instead of the pen going however it went, maybe we go out this way, we could go there and we could turn, link back up over here in the center with more dark oak. Yeah, just like that. This would curve up like that. There we go. And then if a pig jumps up here, that's fine because there's no way it's going to be able to jump over there and get out. Perfect. Problem solved. However, you know, a problem is not solved. Pigs. This is the part that I was not looking forward to, but we need to get pigs. So first, carrots. I know exactly where carrots are. If we just fly over here, there are carrots sitting there. Don't worry, I harvest these other ones sometimes. You just never see it, okay? I promise. Look, so check this out. Beetroot right there, there's a little bit. Over here, carrots, exactly what we're looking for. We'll take that many. And then over here, potatoes. That's nice. But, pigs. So, I don't... Dang it. See, I told you I harvest this sometimes. Pigs. I don't really remember seeing any pigs over here in the jungle. I feel like I maybe saw them, but it has been a long time. Like looking around and thinking about things, there are no pigs anywhere. But we do, however, have a plains biome over here, so maybe we could get lucky and find some... Okay, there's at least one pig. Okay, good. Cool. Horses, endermen, nice. Cows, okay. Oh, pigs. Okay. Oh, parrots. With the bee. What are you guys doing? What are you doing? What? Why are there so many bees leaving me? What? Bird, one of you. You. How about this? I will name you bro. Okay, so anyways, check this out. We have a pig there. Pig. There's so many pigs over here. And there's even more over there, which is perfect. So, let's see. I don't really exactly know where we're going to need to go. I think it's going to be this way somewhere. Let's just bring maybe two pigs. I only really need... Okay, fine. Four. Four is fine. And we'll go into the forest. And the bird... Oh, the bird. That's where it is. Okay, cool. All right, so I hear lava too, and it's a literal wall of plants. So I guess we'll march around the wall this way. We can't be stopped by a wall. No. All right, but apparently half of the pigs can. We have two pigs left. That's fine. It will work. This two is fine, but no less, okay? You two keep up. All right, so awesome. The pig part, though, that's going to be good. And then we're actually just about ready for the villager part too, which is like perfect. I mean, we need to finish up the house and make it look a little bit better. Oh, that's the bee building. That's the bee kingdom. Okay. Oh, look at this. This actually couldn't be any more perfect. We're like literally right next to it. There's the build right there. Just thought about it though. We need to get the windows in that build or the pigs are gonna get out. Not a problem. Hey, keep up. Okay, keep coming. All right, perfect. Look, we can shortcut our way right in here. Yes. This way. Okay. You're trapped in here now. I think I got gates everywhere. We should be good. Breed. There you go. Now, the glass. So I was thinking either brown glass or pink glass because of the pigs, right? Brown because the ground is going to be like muddy looking, but honestly that's a lot of brown there, so let's try the pink. Or no, I meant let's try the pink. It's gonna look a little different, right? But I think using these different color glass colors is kind of fun, honestly. Like the yellow over there, then the pink over here, because pigs. Yeah, that's perfect. By the way, this is where the road is going to go. It's going to turn right here. It's going to go up this way through these trees that I've cleared out. It's going to cut through here. We'll get rid of the vines. It's going to go straight up this way and then right over to this thing. Pretty straightforward. Simple. Okay, you know what? I'm not looking forward to it at all. I have to be honest. I'm really not. Let's go ahead and get the villager part done. All we need to do is move one villager over. Oh, this is perfect. This couldn't be any more perfect. There you go. Get in the boat. Villager breeder turned off. Now you come with me. I think what we're going to... Oh, wait. You're still a child. You're like relatively new. Okay, well, I guess we'll move the baby villager over here and then have it wait in the boat, because to move it easily, we're gonna need the workstation. This should be a pretty safe spot next to the fisher villager. You should be good there. Wait, could a baby zombie get through there? Well, if they could, not anymore. That's perfect. So this might be a little bit dangerous with pigs in here and all, but we need podzol. Podzol, quick and easy, grow the giant trees. So giant tree, boom, there we go. Tons of podzol. Podzol looks really, really good here. I feel like podzol kind of looks like mud, and that's exactly what we need. So podzol in here, and we're gonna chop that off so the pigs can't climb the tree and then jump out of the tree. You know how pigs are. Inside of the house, I wanna do something really cool, something different. It might not go well with a pink glass, but at the same time, it might go really well with a pink glass. I'm thinking warped wood. Warped wood could be really cool in here, and then we can actually open that up a little bit more, which is kind of nice. We'll have to do something with the wall there, but warped wood inside of the house as the floor, I think that would be really cool. This stuff is so interesting looking. It's gonna be a really strange butcher for sure, but it's cool. Heading back outside of the build for this next part, podzol looks like mud, but you know what also looks like mud? Brown concrete powder. So podzol and mud varied on the ground in here. And by mud, I mean brown concrete powder all over the place. That is going to be the ground in here. I think that's going to look really good. We might spill it past the fence a little bit to make it look more realistic. But yeah, that's going to be the ground. And actually, also, because why not? Or, well, actually, because we're nice, we'll put a water pond in here. But that's going to mean that this fence gate needs to go. That's kind of in a bad spot. Okay, so this area over here, this is going to be a fireplace somehow. We need to make it work. So, right off the bat, I think we could maybe build this thing up like that. And then maybe I was thinking, this is a little risky with the villagers here, but I was thinking campfires in here. So maybe we put a campfire right there. And then another one right there. That'll be cool. Then to stop the villagers from jumping on top of the campfire, I think what we could maybe do are some signs. I think this should stop the villager, right? If I put signs there, can I jump up here? Yeah, I can't jump up there. Or I guess because the campfire is kind of tall, I probably wouldn't have been able to in the first place. Perfect. Then I think we could do staircases in here going towards the center like that, and then maybe a couple more staircases in there, and then probably stone bricks all the way up. It's just like that. And then boom, there we go. We have a fireplace in here, which looks really cool. And then the cobblestone can poke through, which will look good. All that I need to do is get some cracked stone bricks and some mossy stone bricks. All right, all I can say is it better be time. Oh, it is time. Perfect. And to make things even better, this is another jungle. Villager, you're beautiful. Let's go this way. Let's think about this. I think maybe this way. Whoops, sorry, lily pad. Yep, I gotta get more lily pads. But I think this way is probably gonna be the best bet. So the villager is gonna walk around. Oh, no. Yeah. You're gonna walk around a little bit. So what we're gonna try and do is use the workstation. No talking to your friend. We're gonna use the workstation to move this villager all the way up and around somehow. Now, I don't know if going... Wait, where are you going? Where are you? No. Okay, this is gonna be a nightmare. This is gonna be so hard. Okay, so I guess what I'm gonna have to do is just remove every single workstation along the way. Probably. It's gonna be tricky, and then we'll put them back after. But the end of the day is happening, so I think what I should probably do is wait till morning. So you're gonna try and sleep, probably soon. You could just get in the boat, though. No sleeping tonight. Okay. Okay, that's fine. That's great. Yeah, move right back to basically where we started, why don't you? Yeah, you're amazing. You're great. Hey, really? Maybe we'll go through the panda exhibit. Yeah, so the thing that maybe makes this the most difficult is the fact that this villager is just going to do whatever it wants. So what I think we want to do is just try and highly encourage it. We technically don't need to only use this workstation. We could use any workstation. It doesn't matter. As long as we don't trade with the villager, we'll be good. So how about your career? Look, your job. Go work. Make money. Yep. Okay, you're working. Okay, look, you're going to work up the hill now. Look, it's perfect. You got this. Look, big brain. No. Okay. Look, maybe we could do this. Could we strategically place workstations? And so look, like we have a trail of workstations leading up this way. So what I'm going to do here is all we need is three workstations. So we're going to take that, and then you're going to look and you're going to realize, hey, look, I'm a fisherman now, which is great. That's good. Then what we're going to do is we're going to take this away, and then you're going to realize, hey, look, there's another job right here for you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Notice the job. Okay. No, you don't want that job. That's fine. You don't need that job. Now, since you're up here, oh, you better go quicker than that, dude. Now look, since you're up here, I could probably do this. Okay, it's in the boat for now, but we could probably put a workstation like right in there, right? Okay, and then I could take this one away and take that one away. Okay, that's good. Now, this is the tricky one. I think we could hold this open for you, and then maybe you'll move through it. Will I be able to trust you, or should I try and... I don't know. Better way. Here we go. We just remove the door, and we sail the villager right on through. Apparently, the carpet is too tall, though. So let me get this. A pressure plate. That's cool. That's fine. But carpet, way too tall. Way too tall. Could never. I understand completely. It's okay. The path? Okay, the path works. So, look, that was genius. That basically was perfect. All we need to do is set it up to do it again. We're getting pretty close now. And just so we don't lose any progress, we're gonna block that off right there, and we're gonna block this off right there. Hi, Pam, holding it down. All right, so nope, go. Okay, this job is the first job. Technically true, I'll give you that one. Your next job is gonna be right here. It's this one, all right? Yeah, it works. Okay, now your next job is gonna go up there. Okay, this is amazing. You're stuck on a fence, that's fine. We'll jump up here. Let me help you. Okay, yeah, no, you don't need any help. You're big brain, okay. Now look, your next career is right there. Oh, look at this. This guy is evolving. It's getting so smart now. Okay. Now I don't know where it's going right now. I'm making me a little nervous, but we'll set it up right here. Home stretch, nice and easy. Where did you go? Okay, no, don't you dare. Okay, come back to your job. Okay, you're gonna stand here. Now look, your next job is right there. Good sir. And now technically, actually, look at this. We're in the home stretch. We could just use a boat. We could just sail the boat right over there, which is exactly what I'm gonna do. Oh my God, it worked. That is amazing. Okay, so we'll jump the villager in like this. and then like this, and then like this. By the way, the pigs have jumped inside of the pen on their own. They've chosen a life of farm. Okay, no way. This is kind of crazy to move a villager through workstations basically and just keep jumping them over each other. That's like insane. That's amazing. Now, hopefully I can remember where all of these workstations went. No, bad. But what? Okay. That's fine. That makes sense. No, don't do that. Okay, so I don't know what career it thinks it sees, but it thinks it sees something over this way, which is not good. Maybe if we just trap you and we force you. Look, buddy, go that way. There's a job right there. Perfectly suitable. Next job over there. No. Okay, that's valid. Next job is over there. Okay. We're so close. Okay. Now, look, this is the big... Where'd you go? Okay, there you are. Okay, look, dude, the pigs are getting out. Go into the pen. Perfect. Okay, you're there. Now all I need is my carrots, which I think are inside of the house. Okay, no big deal. Pig, make your way back on over. Perfect. The villagers here, the pigs are here. Everything is good. And now all we need to do is get the actual villager to go inside of there. No, there's no job over there. It's right over here inside of your new house. Come on, don't be disrespectful like that. No. Yep, so that light pole's not gonna work there, but to give the villager some credit, it sees the job. It knows that there's something in there. It's just going the wrong way to the job. So what if we cut that off? You can go right through the building, you know. That would technically work. Well, surprise, surprise, the villager's not listening. We'll row you back in here just like that. I've moved that. That was really bad. This one you shouldn't be able to get up on top of. Same with that one. I think I got up on top of this one because of that right there. But you know what? Just to be safe, I'm not gonna take it. Okay, yeah, the pig is out somehow. Yep, those have to move. Okay, let's try that again. Freedom, free at last. There you go. You walk right in there. I don't know if it's gonna take the job quite yet, but we'll put the door there. And I thought about it. The villager, it might not be able to actually get through this door. I know the pigs can. They're too wide. I don't know if the villager's gonna have the same problem. But here we go. Here is the finished house. You really should clean the place up some more. I don't know what that is, but I do like your taste in art. You have one redeeming quality. Your name, it will be H. Oh, great, it's in the chest too. That's wonderful. That's amazing. Okay, so basically, it's too late in the day. I think the villager isn't going to work until tomorrow. No big deal. That gives us a little bit of time to finish stuff up here. So, it's really plain and empty. Bamboo could be cool here, but if it grows up, it's not going to look good. So, I'm thinking short little bamboo sprout plants all over the place. That might look cool. It definitely fits this whole aesthetic. And check this out. So, while I was working on this build, a couple pigs actually jumped inside of this thing on their own. So, that's good to go. I went ahead and closed it up. I bred the pigs. Now all we need to do is continue that cycle over and over and over again, just like with the cow crusher. I will also leave a couple pigs roaming around out here. I think that looks nice. Now, the plan here. This butcher villager, come on, take the job. What is your problem? You can't get to the job? There you go. So, oh, right off the bat, pork chop level 1. Okay, that's amazing. I forgot my emeralds though, so don't lose that trait. I'll be right back. Okay, so was saying, we're gonna have pigs all over this place. It's gonna be perfect. This villager is going to have this raw pork chop trade at level 1. We'll be able to breed the pigs up inside of that pig crusher, and then we'll get a bunch of pork chop eventually. Instead of cooking the pork chop up, we'll take it over to this butcher villager right here, sell it to the butcher, and make tons of profit. Let's see, what do you have on level 2? Anything good? A coal trade. Okay, that's cool. That's nice, and then we could purchase that from you too. That's cool. It looks like if we want to level you up again, that's going to be the trade. This is getting really painful right off the bat. But, I mean, it's okay, I guess. For the sake of leveling you up, we'll buy this a couple times. Here we go. All right, one more trade. There you go. You took too many emeralds from me. Now what? Okay. Now you have raw mutton and raw beef, which is amazing. That's really easy. Now, unfortunately, right now, I actually don't have very much raw beef stockpiled, and I have zero raw mutton stockpiled at all. So, what I'm gonna need to do is wait for this pig farm to actually get productive, because then I'll be able to sell pork chop to this villager and make tons of emeralds really, really easily. We could even discount the price if we wanted to, but gamers, we still haven't even seen the best trade quite yet. And Bad news, we're not going to see it today. Suggestion, you should do another wither fight to make more beacons, or make it more exciting, two withers at the same time. Yeah, so you kind of actually read my mind, actually. So we're doing the villager project right now, working on a couple villager things, but hopefully before episode 100, the goal is to actually take on another wither. Right now, in my stockpile, I actually have enough wither skeleton skulls for two wither fights. Will I do two at the same time? I'm not too sure if we're doing that quite yet. We definitely need to upgrade the gear first. Like, it's a netherite sword, right? But it doesn't even have sharpness 5. So we need better tools. The armor is pretty much on point, but the tools. So what I'm thinking is wither fight soon, probably. But we have a little bit more work that needs to get done, especially with this villager right here. I just thought about it. Maybe I'll add some dead bushes in here too. That might look kind of cool. That's going to be it for today's episode of the guide, though. I'll see you next time. Today, big shout out to my patrons, Violet Pirate and Medico Boomstick. Thank you so much for the support. I can read your mind. You've already hit like, you've already subscribed, you've been in that notification gang. So thank you so much. I'll see you next time. Bye.